Welcome back to Upfront. The Environmental Protection Agency last week laid out plans for curbing pollution from coal-fired power plants. The EPA gave states new goals and a timeline for reducing the carbon dioxide gases blamed for climate change. In Wisconsin, that's a 34% reduction by 2030. Is it achievable? And what might be the cost? We're asking Alliant Energy CEO Patricia Kampling, who joins us from our Madison affiliate, WKOW-TV. Pat Kampling, thanks very much for being with us today. Let me get your first read on these new goals. Environmentalists are cheering these goals. They say it's a great thing, that these goals are very achievable, but yet you hear people in business and some lawmakers say they're job killers and it's going to result in higher utility fees. What's your take on it?
Sure. First, these goals are quite complicated. We're still going through the documentation as they were presented to us, but keep in mind what was issued earlier this week was a framework. But what's in the framework is definitely ambitious, but we believe that it has enough flexibility that we can work with our state to make sure we have an implementation plan that's achievable and also cost-effective for our customers.
You say ambitious. By ambitious, I take that to mean that, you know, they're pretty bold in terms of what needs to be done by 2030.
Yeah, the reductions are large. Keep in mind, though, for our state and actually our company, we've already reduced carbon emissions by about 15%. And again, carbon is something that you can't put a box on a facility and have the carbon go down. It's actually burning less coal or making the plants more efficient. But we've already made great progress on reducing carbon emissions already. But these are ambitious goals, and we just have to make sure the plan is flexible enough that we actually can achieve them on the time frame that was laid out.
I want to ask you something that I asked of Gale Klappa, the WE Energy CEO, about a year ago when this was first being discussed. And he said, it's key for the government to take into consideration the progress we've already made, that this needs to be considered as part of this. Based on your first reading of this, has this been taken into consideration?
Yes, it has. And that was a very big point with the utility industry, to make sure that all the progress we've already made was considered in these goals. And it appears on the surface that it was. We just have to make sure that when the rules are written, that we get full credit for everything that we've already put in place.
How long before you will know what this means for your customers, for instance?
I think we'll probably have a good handle in about a year. Again, we've made a lot of progress on this environmental front without increasing customer costs by a lot. But as we get to the details, it's really going to be so important what these details are and what you get credit for, and what actually counts in reducing carbon. One of the things that's important for the state of Wisconsin is we have great energy efficiency programs. We want to make sure that gets counted. We already have renewable programs in place. We want to make sure that gets counted. So once we work with the state and figure out what the implementation plans are, we'll know for sure. But we'll make sure that we request all the items that'll make sure it's the most advantageous for our customers to reduce the costs. There is going to be costs associated with this. We want to make sure we have a plan that has the lowest cost to our customers.
I want to have you address something that the critics of this plan say, and I think you may have touched on this a bit in your first answer. I mean, the carbon dioxide emissions are not in a box, and one of the arguments against the dramatic nature of these cuts, at least according to some, is that places like China, places like India, are not playing by the same rules we are in terms of carbon dioxide emissions. We can reduce ours, but they may not be reducing theirs. So the net effect is not all that great. Is that a concern of yours?
Sure. You know, we all care about clean air and clean water. Everybody does. This is a global issue, just not a United States issue. I'm pleased that the United States has taken a leadership position in this, but this is larger than the United States. And the president has basically said that as well. But this is a bigger issue that we need to address globally.
There has been this move towards natural gas. Right now, the prices are pretty favorable, but I guess the concern long term is, do they remain at that level as we continue to invest more heavily in that industry?
And we believe that natural gas prices, just because of the surplus of gas in this United States, they will remain very competitive, and it will be a good fuel source for us to use going forward for our emission controls programs.
All right. Pat Kampling is the CEO of Alliant Energy. We appreciate your time today. Thanks very much for being with us.
Thank you, Mike.